How about the story where, I mean, incredible development where new polls are showing that the GOP image that has gotten bad, that it's even going worse. And the real story here, Bobby, is that you know, what's happening is there are no more factions. There aren't enough factions. Let me put it this way. There aren't enough factions to hold the GOP together anymore. You know, the neocons are fighting the theocons. The conservatives are blaming the moderates. The evangelicals are blaming the business non-evangelicals. It's a disaster. And in light of that, you have only 34. This is a staggering number. Only 34% of the American public say that they have favorable views of the GOP. That's down 40%. That's down 40%.
But even more significant, 61% of Americans have an unfavorable view of the Republican Party. It's those unfavorable ratings, the highest polling, the highest ever in history of the polling organization is recorded for the GOP since they started polling on those numbers, a Gallup poll. So it's and meanwhile, 55% of Americans hold a favorable opinion of the Democratic Party, and you know this is well deserved, as you say. This is the product of, listen, for 27 years they were telling us that liberalism was wrong, that liberal ideas were wrong, that progressive politics were wrong, that the free market was God, that we had to get rid of all regulations, that government was a bad thing, that it was the enemy of the people. And finally, people said, okay, let's give them a chance. They got control of the Senate. They got control of the House. They got control of the White House and a lot of the judiciary. And they were able, without any interference, to put their entire package into action. And what did we get? We got Hurricane Katrina, the destruction of our ninth largest city. We got the worst war, the biggest foreign policy disaster in the history of our country by far, a $4.5 trillion war in Iraq that we should have never gotten into. We got the biggest economic collapse, at least since the Depression. We have our entire corporate structure now being socialized because their form of free market deregulation was such a catastrophe for our country. We have really literally catastrophes in every area of domestic
environmental
and foreign
policy. We had
the destruction of our environment. And destruction
of constitutional rights. I mean, how far have we fallen?
The abolition of habeas corpus, the torturing of Americans, the erosion and subversion of our Bill of Rights, the illegally eavesdropping on 300,000 people, the growth of a police state in our country, which is supposed to be free of a police state.
Yeah, the bastardization of the Justice Department. When have we ever had that?
Right. The total politicization and corruption of the Justice Department, the no-bid contracts, Ahmed Chalabi this weekend wrote an article for the New York Times, and this is their guy, their neocon, the head chief neocon guy, and he called the Bush policy in Iraq the biggest scandal of corporate corruption and theft in the history of mankind. This is the rebuilding efforts, the reconstruction efforts, that it was the largest theft of money and resources in the history of mankind.
We won't even really see it for quite a while now. Hey, look, let's change gears. Look, Waxman wins. Okay, great, great. I mean, I've always been very suspect of John Dingell. Waxman, now he's wrested control of the U.S. House of Representatives. Energy.
Dingell for, 30 years has been in the tank with Detroit, with the automakers, fighting for SUVs, fighting against seatbelts, fighting against airbags, fighting against fuel efficiency, essentially dooming the industry that, he claimed to love.
Right, right.
To the very, very predictable outcome where we are today, which we've been saying for years and years, you are digging your own grave by relying on these SUVs rather than innovating and trying to leapfrog the Japanese and get into electric. He's safeguarded that. He was voted out, and that's a good thing.